In this video, we're going to be looking at multiplying one matrix by another matrix. So for my first question, I have A, a 2x2 matrix, and I have B, another 2x2 matrix. So in part one of my question, I have A multiplied by B, and part two, I have B multiplied by A. So for part one, I have A in blue and B in green. So this is my matrix A here in blue, and this is my matrix B here in green. Now A is a 2x2 matrix, meaning two rows and two columns. So we have two rows and two columns, so this is the order of the matrix. And likewise, B is the same thing, another 2x2 matrix. Now once these two inner numbers are the same, it means we can multiply the two matrices. And the order of the answer is given by the two end numbers. So this is a 2 and this is a 2. Therefore, the order of the answer would be a 2x2 matrix. So again, these two inner numbers are the same. Therefore, we can multiply the two matrices. And the end numbers would give the order of the answer. So the answer would be a 2x2 matrix. So now when multiplying two matrices, we multiply rows in the first matrix by columns in the second matrix. So I'll have my rows in the first matrix multiplied by columns in the second matrix. Now, since I expect my answer to be a 2x2 matrix, I'll have a number here, here, and here. Now, if I want to get a number here, this will be in the first row, first column. So I'll be using this 2 and negative 1 with this 10 and negative 3 to get the number here. And if I want the number here, this will be in the first row, second column. So I'll be using my first row here and second column from here. So I'll be using the 2 and negative 1 with the 7 and 0 to give the answer for here. Likewise, down here, this would be in the second row, first column. So I'll be using my second row, first column to get the number for here. And the number for this position would be in the second row, second column. So I'll be using my second row, second column to get the number for here. So first I'll multiply the 2 by 10 plus negative 1 by negative 3. Then to get my number for across here, I'll be multiplying 2 by 7 plus negative 1 by 0. Then to get my number for down here, I'll be multiplying 4 by 10 plus 5 by negative 3. Then to get my number for here, I'll be multiplying 4 by 7 plus 5 by 0. So you can clearly see with the colors that the blue is from the first matrix and the green is from the second matrix. So on this first row, you are seeing 2 and negative 1 repeated, 2 and negative 1. And that's the 2 and negative 1 from this first row here. In this first column, in green, you are seeing the 10 and negative 3, 10 and negative 3. And that's from the first column here. In my second row, in blue, I'm seeing the 4 and 5 repeated, 4 and 5. And that's from the second row here, 4 and 5. And in my second column, in green, I'm seeing 7 and 0 repeated, 7 and 0. And that's from the 7 and 0 here in the second column. So now I'll work this out and get my answer. So I'll have 2 by 10 is 20 plus negative 1 by negative 3 will just give positive 3. So I'll have 20 plus 3. Then down here, I'll have 4 by 10 is 40 plus 5 by negative 3 is negative 15. So that'll be 40 take away 15. Then across here, I'll have 2 by 7 is 14 and negative 1 by 0 is 0. So that'll just give 14. And down here, I'll have 4 sevens are 28 and 5 times 0 is 0. So I'll just have 28. So 20 plus 3 is 23. And 40 take away 15 is 25. And this is your answer for multiplying matrix A by the matrix B. So for part 2 of my question, I have B times A. So I have B in green and A in blue. So this is my matrix B in green and my matrix A in blue. Again, we have a 2x2 matrix multiplied by a 2x2 matrix. Our answer would be a 2x2 matrix. So I'll be multiplying rows in my first matrix by columns in my second matrix. So for the number that's going here in this spot, first row, first column, I'll be multiplying this row by this column. So that's 10 by 2 plus 7 by 4. And for the number that's coming here, this will be in the first row but second column. So this will be my first row here with my second column here. So I'll be multiplying 10 by negative 1 plus 7 by 5. And now for the number that's coming down here, this will be my second row, first column. So this is my second row here, first column here. So this will be negative 3 by 2 plus 0 by 4. And now for my answer that's coming here, this will be in the second row, second column. So I'm multiplying this row here by this column here. So I'll have negative 3 by negative 1 plus 0 by 5. So now I'll work this out and get my answer. So 10 by 2 is 20 plus 7 by 4 is 28. So I have 20 plus 28. Then coming across here, negative 1 by 10 is negative 10 plus 7 by 5 is 35. So that's negative 10 plus 35. Then coming down here, I'll have negative 3 by 2 is negative 6 plus 0 by 4 is 0. So that'll just give you negative 6. And then across here, I'll have negative 3 by negative 1, which is positive 3, plus 0 by 5. And 0 by 5 is 0, so you'll just have the positive 3. So 20 plus 28 is 48. And negative 10 plus 35 is positive 25. Now if we look at our answer for BA, we have 48, 25, negative 6, and 3. And if we go back and look at our answer for AB, it's 23, 14, 25, and 28. Hence, AB and BA are not equal to each other. So matrix multiplication is not commutative. So in my second question, I have the matrix P, which has one row and two columns. So this is a 1 by 2 matrix. And I have my matrix Q here, which has two rows and one column. So this is a 2 by 1 matrix. I want to find what is P multiplied by Q and Q multiplied by P. So here I have my matrix P in blue. So this is my matrix P here in blue. And my matrix Q is in green. So this is my matrix here, Q in green. Now, as I said, the matrix P has one row and two columns. So this is a 1 by 2 matrix. And the matrix Q has two rows and one column. So that's a 2 by 1 matrix. Now, seeing that these two middle numbers here are the same, that means we can multiply these two matrices. And the n numbers will give the order of the answer. So the answer will just be a 1 by 1 matrix. So we just get one number in the brackets. So now knowing that I'll just have one number in the brackets, I'll multiply this row here by this column here. So I'll multiply 1 by 4 plus negative 5 by 6. And now I'll just work this out and get my answer. So 1 by 4 is 4 plus negative 5 by 6 is negative 30. So I'll have 4 take away 30. And 4 take away 30 is negative 26. And this would be my answer for multiplying the matrix P times the matrix Q. So here are part 2 of my question. We have the matrix Q now multiplied by matrix P. So Q comes first, then P. So this is Q here in green and P here in blue. Now remember, the matrix Q has 2 rows and 1 column. So that's a 2 by 1 matrix. And the matrix P has 1 row and 2 columns. So that's a 1 by 2 matrix. Now we can see that we have these middle numbers being the same. Therefore, we can multiply these two matrix because these two numbers here are the same. And the order of our answer would be the n numbers, which would be a 2 by 2 matrix. So the answer would be a 2 by 2 matrix. So for my answer, I'm expecting to get a number here, a number here, here, and here. So now this position would be the first row, first column. So 4 would be my first row here, and my first column would be the 1 here. So you can look at it this way, that these are the rows here by the columns in the second matrix here. So if we're looking here at our first row, first column, then this will be the first row, first column. So 4 by 1 will give you the number for here. And if you want the number for here, this will be the first row, second column. So this will be my first row, this will be my second column. So 4 by negative 5 would give you the number for here. Then if I want the number for here, this will be the second row, first column. So this will be my second row, first column. So 6 by 1 will give the answer for here. And the number for here would be in my second row, second column. So this is my second row, second column. So 6 by negative 5 will give the answer for here. So now I'll work this out and get my answer for Q times P. So 4 by 1 is 4, 6 by 1 is 6, 4 by negative 5 is negative 20, and 6 by negative 5 is negative 30. And that will be my answer for Q times P. Now again, we can see the answer for P times Q is not the same as the answer for Q times P. So again, matrix multiplication is not commutative.